delays.
The budget fight in Washington could affect the safety of air travel in Wisconsin. The Federal Aviation Administration says it will have to cut $600 million in costs. Cuts that include employee furloughs and air traffic control cutbacks. New at 6, WISN 12 News' Nick Bohr is live at Mitchell International Airport, where they've just learned the cuts could close the control tower overnight.
And Kathy, it's a proposal perhaps intended to shock as the country hurtles toward another so-called fiscal cliff. This latest warning coming from the FAA saying that it could have some major cuts to air traffic controllers like the ones here at the tower at Mitchell International that could impact safety and snarl air traffic. Pilots across the country and here at Mitchell International rely on the air traffic control system to prevent disaster. So a warning of potentially steep cuts in staffing by the Federal Aviation Administration doesn't sit well with travelers.
I like to know that the flight coming in has a good tower to be able to land and the safety that's involved with that.
Something that you think about on the plane.
Yes. It brings a certain comfort level to knowing that there's actual people behind the landing of the plane.
Safety issues aside, the cuts would kick in April 1st, barring some resolution in Congress, potentially snarling air traffic at peak spring break travel time. At Mitchell International and 60 other airports, the FAA says the control tower would be shut down overnight, meaning ground control could be left up to the pilots to sort out. And more than 100 other airports, including Milwaukee's Timmerman, Kenosha, and Waukesha, control towers would be closed down.
I personally like flying in, you know, environments that are controlled with the control tower, absolutely. I think many pilots would miss that.
Zach Shabla is a flight instructor at Timmerman and hopes the staffing cuts can be avoided.
The tower is really instrumental in really just, you know, helping pilots all maintain situational awareness.
Which basically means not running into each other, right?
Exactly, that's true.
A Mitchell Airport referred us to the FAA for comments, saying that it is a federal budget issue. The FAA didn't return our calls. I did speak with the Air Traffic Controllers Union. They say it's still too early to say exactly how this might affect them. The deadline for reaching that budget deal is March 1st. Live at Mitchell International Airport, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.